Ladies and gentlemen, the President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee. Please remain standing for the National Anthem of India. Thank you. Please be seated.
Honorable President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, Honorable Ministers, Sri Sarad Pawar, Sri Harish Rawat, Sri Srikant Jena, Director General of ICAR, Dr. Ayappan, my colleagues on dais, fellow industrialists, scientists, farmers, students, press, invited guests from all over the world. I have a great pleasure in welcoming you all to this conference on doubling the food production in 5 years. Only with proper care to agriculture, India can achieve its target of economic growth and social changes. Because of more than 50% of our population depends on agriculture for their livelihood. India has witnessed all-round development in this sector last couple of years. The country recorded bumper harvest by farm extension work or private-public partnership. This year, this helped the food grain production to record high of 235 million tons. There was also impressive growth in other agriculture products, and forecast for this year is even better. Last year, we exported US$37 billion worth of rice, cotton, sugar, marine product, beef, and guar gum. We can prove that in long term, Indian agriculture is globally competitive. In fact, many experts who have studied the Indian agriculture potential have mentioned that India can become food basket of the world. With inputs like hybrid seeds, soil testing, crop protection, farm equipment, farmers have achieved a great success. But in spite of excellent growth in food production, we have fallen short of our target. Keeping the agriculture production ahead of population growth is a very challenging task for the farmers, our scientists in research institute and industry associated with agriculture. Private sector has been playing an important role. We produce quality crop protection chemical, we have hybrid seed producing, fertilizers, farm machinery, and irrigation system. Banks and financial institutes will have to play a very important role. The challenge before us is to double agriculture production in next 5 years. In many extension programs in private sector has been successful in doing just in a couple of years. If we can achieve success in one area, we should repeat in all over the country. The problem in our rural sector is abject poverty, illiteracy, health, nutrition, sanitation, and lack of infrastructure. The biggest problem faced in India today is from environmentalists. They have a little respect for science. I sometimes wonder that their aim is to keep India poor and hungry. We in Crop Care Federation of India, with our colleagues in private sector units, along with the Government Research Institute, are confident that we will be able to make India an important producer of agriculture products. With support of input from all over the world, we have guessed here, we will double the food production in India in 5 years. Thank you.
Respected Chief Guest, Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee Sahab, Honorable Union Minister of Agriculture and Food Processing Industries, Shri Sharad Pawar Sahab, Honorable Union Minister of Water Resources, Government of India, Shri Harish Rawat Ji, Honorable Union Minister of State, Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, Shri Shrikant Kumar Jena Ji, Chairman CCFI, Mr. Rajesh Shroff, Chairman Godrej Agrovet, Mr. Nadir Godrej, Managing Director Mahiko, Mr. Raju Barwale, Coordinator CCFI, Mr. Kalyan Banerjee, Esteemed Secretary of the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, Government of India, Mr. Ashish Bahuguna, distinguished invitees and delegates to the conference from India and overseas, members of the press and media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Thanks to the Crop Care Foundation of India for this initiative at the beginning of the 12th five-year plan in this country with a specific theme of doubling food production. Indian agriculture with a complete paradigm of agriculture to food, to nutrition, to environment, to health, and also employment is a saga of millions of farmers of this country. Having crossed the 100 million ton mark in the annual rice production last year, we are heading to a similar performance in wheat much before the target. Horticulture, as all of you know, animal husbandry and aquaculture segments have also been showing growth rates of 4-6% annually with appreciable diversification of Indian agriculture. This is the confidence with which we have assembled here to discuss doubling the food production with a combination of new tools, techniques and technologies, infrastructure, policies and investments. The question is also that whether we should double food production across or in selected crops and commodities with the emphasis on shift from food security to nutrition security, emphasis from starch to protein, changes in production consumption patterns, the supply demand dynamics, also with concerns, for example, on imports of pulses and oil seeds, we must be emphasizing today that focus needs to be on doubling their production. Following economic transition, India is bound to experience dietary transitions. Demands for cereals is expected to rise in the region of about 1.5% per annum, while that for pulses by 3%, vegetables and fruits by 4%, meat, milk, fish and eggs around 5%. This underscores the need for prioritization of portfolios. Doubling food production while looking into the resources, the climate change patterns, biotic and abiotic stresses, emerging pests and diseases, post-harvest losses also needs to consider the absorption capacities in the demand side. Projections are that effective management of pests and weeds could easily reduce the losses by 10-15%, to be specific, about 18% across crops, and proper post-harvest management by another 15%. So deployment of tools for enhancing input use efficiencies, producing climate resilient crop varieties and animal breeds, effective health management, customized farm mechanization, very important for this country, precision farming and protected cultivation, value addition, nutraceuticals and functional foods, for example, and food safety are the areas needing attention at this stage, with a focus on increasing productivity with profits, which I would like to underline, productivity enhancement with profits to the farmer. Given the context and the canvas, a systems approach is the need for smart farming for small farmers. That is the prime canvas of this country. The new sciences, power of science and technology, whether it's biotechnology, the omics, the nanotechnology, the information communication technology, offer immense opportunities. with the knowledge-based agriculture as the way forward, Indian asset is also today the youth, like no other countries in the world. I'd not like to go into details, 40% easily. And at this time, what we need is to equip them with skills, integrate and innovate and invest in agriculture. This conference is further very important for emphasizing